Along the Platte River tonight, one of nature's most delicate balancing acts. After ice jams caused major headaches last winter and mild temperatures tonight, authorities are keeping a close eye on the ice. KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews is live with the story you're seeing new at 10.
Our camera followed Papio Missouri River NRD experts as they checked various sites along the Platte, Brandy. Their goal, to keep tabs on whether the ice is decaying and how well the water is flowing there, a critical task this time of year.
From flows to broken pieces to the solid stuff, ice may make the Platte River look like a winter wonderland, but to this team from the Papio Missouri River NRD,
this spot did have some openings last week.
This scene is a lab experiment waiting to go awry.
When the ice is thick and it breaks up quickly, that's what causes the ice jams.
Amanda Grint is poring over some 8 stretches of the Platte, including this one near Fairview Road, to check on how the ice is holding up in key areas.
Doing our weekly observations on the Platte and the Elkhorn, checking the ice. Last week it was pretty well intact and all frozen.
But this week, somewhat milder temperatures have, in places, thinned out the ice. You can see the water just below the surface in some spots. Grant and her assistant take readings and write them down.
We check how high it is to the bank, how much of water is open water, if there's ice flowing in the open water.
Their goal, to stay well ahead of the situation, just in case even higher temperatures down the road this winter cause a repeat of what happened here last winter. That's when rapid ice breakup led to jams and, in turn, flooding, which forced evacuations of low-lying areas. Now, there's no sign of anything like that today, but Grant knows that this most delicate of nature's balancing acts can take a very quick turn, so her team will be back here next week, continuing their watch.
We check for evidence of decay on the ice.
Now the NRD team takes its readings and compiles them and finally posts them to the NRD website. In that way, area emergency managers can get the latest information on ice levels.